Hello everyone, this is João, and today I'm going to show you a fun and efficient way to learn the main bones of the skeletal system. And you might be asking, João, are you going to teach us how to become grave robbers? Teach us how to use bones to learn anatomy like they used to in the 19th century? And my answer is, of course! No, I don't want any lawsuits, so please don't come for me. Please. The methods I'm going to show you are a lot cleaner and legal. We're going to do that with worksheets and quizzes. First thing we're going to do is go to kenhub.com and type in skeletal system quizzes, and you can pick the article Learn the Bones of the Body with Skeletal System Quizzes. For a shortcut, I will leave the link in this video's description below. In this page, you can click on the free labeling diagrams, which will take you to these buttons here. Before you start labeling diagrams, I recommend that you review your knowledge on the main bones of the human body. To do that, you can first use this button to download the labeled sheet. And here you can see all the bones we will be learning today. Alternatively, you can also use this image in the article with an overview of all the main bones. Spend 5 to 10 minutes looking at these labels, or watch this video as I will show you how to label this diagram. You should now be ready to label the sheet. Let's click on this button where you can download the blank worksheet PDF. Then it is time to print. Now, this is where you can check whether your review was effective. Fill the rectangles with the names of the bones. I'll start with those that I'm more familiar with, usually the larger bones, like the humerus or the femur. Then fill in as many as I remember. We can then start looking at the bones and splitting them into location. Let's continue labeling the bones of the axial skeleton. The axial skeleton forms the main frame of the body, the bones of the head and trunk. Here in the skull, we have three bones to label. The bone of the forehead, which is known as the frontal bone. On the left, we have the bone that houses the upper teeth, the maxilla. Just below, we have the lower jaw, or the mandible. The vertebral column, or spine, is also part of the axial skeleton. We can see this label here, which we can just write spine, since it includes several thoracic and lumbar vertebrae. Below the spine, right below the lumbar vertebrae, we find this bone here known as the sacrum. And right at the lower end, this tiny triangular bone is called the coccyx, the well-known tailbone. In the axial skeleton, we also have a structure called thoracic cage, which comprises the ribs and the sternum. Okay, so here on my diagram, I can see this label pointing at the sternum. And this one, which is specifically pointing at one part of the sternum called the manubrium. Here you can find this tip, which is still part of the sternum and is called the xiphoid process. All the labels for the axial skeleton are complete, so we will continue now with the appendicular skeleton. Remember, the appendicular skeleton bones are essentially the appendages that hang or append from the axial skeleton. Let's then identify the two bones that form the pectoral girdle. This famous bone, or infamous bone, known for its fractures, the clavicle, and the triangularly shaped scapula. We can now continue on with the bones of the upper limb, which include this one that I've already labeled, the humerus, and continue distally to label the two bones of the forearm. Since this model is in the anatomical position, meaning with the palms of the hands facing forward, we can assume this bone here is the radius, just in line with the thumb. And this bone here is the ulna, found more medially. On the right side of the diagram, there is also this label pointing at the hand or wrist. Carpal bones are essentially the bones of the wrist. And in addition to the bones of the wrist, you have the metacarpal bones and phalanges, which together make up all the bones of the hand. And we're done with the upper limb. Time to move down towards the pelvis, where we have a few labels to look at. We have this label pointing at one of the hip bones, known as the ischium. Right in the middle of the pelvis, we find here this label pointing at one of the pubic bones. And at the top, we see clearly the ilium spreading its wings. But no, these wings, unfortunately, were not made for flying. We are done with the hip bones. Time to travel down to the lower limb. Here we can identify the femur, which we've labeled before. Right over the knee, we find this round bone called the patella, or the famous kneecap. As for the bones of the leg, I can find laterally the thinner one, which is the fibula, and the thicker one, medially, the tibia. And after labeling this, I'm ready, tibia, a master in bone anatomy. Get it? Tibia? Okay, moving on. Right at the lower portion, we find this lonely label, which is simply pointing at the foot. We can just write foot. As for the bones of the foot, we are now done with the bones of the appendicular skeleton. You might be asking,
so João, why are there so many labels left?
Well, I left those for last because they are, wait for it, joints. Yes, my friend, joints. As you know, joints are connections between bones. So best to identify the bones first, like we just did, and now the joints. The first one, which we can see here right between the humerus and scapula, we find then the shoulder joint. Still in the upper limb, we find another important joint called the elbow joint, formed between the humerus, ulna, and radius. Further down, we can see this label pointing at the joint between the sacrum and ilium. It is then called the sacroiliac joint. See, in anatomy, we're super creative when it comes to naming joints. You're welcome. On the left side of the diagram, we have this label pointing at one of the two hip joints formed between the femur and the acetabulum of the hip bone. Between the two pubic bones, we find the pubic symphysis, which is a cartilaginous joint. And that is it. We have here our labeled diagram. All pretty. As you try to label these on your own, if there are some bones that you don't remember, go back to the labeled image and check the answers. Or rewatch the part of the video where we label everything. Then go back again to the blank sheet and fill in the remaining terms. Do that as many times until you're able to fill all the labels at once without checking the label diagram. Hopefully you're now feeling more confident about identifying the main bones of the human body. So it's time to take things to the next level. Yes, we're talking about quizzes. These are the best way to identify any gaps in your knowledge to be then revised later. Alternatively, you can use our bone quizzes to learn about the anatomy of the bones of the body from scratch. And after answering a few questions, our clever algorithm will learn where your weak points lie and give you more questions on those topics accordingly. Just like studying with that friend that asks you the right questions. How would I know that? I don't have any friends. We recommend starting out with the basic identification bone quizzes. And once that starts to feel too easy, you can challenge yourself with the advanced identification quizzes. And if you're feeling really, really confident, I mean, really confident, you can move on to our clinical question banks. Check out some of our topics for quizzes on the bones of the human body in the worksheet link I left in the video's description. And in addition to quizzes, we have a lot more fun videos, complete articles, and an atlas section covering every detail on bone anatomy. Oh, and don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel for more videos like this one. I will see you next time. Without checking the labels, teaches how to become anatomy. I need breath. I can't catch my breath. Take my breath away. Anyway.